Good morning, friends. I would like to discuss something about a screwjack. The definition of a screwjack is it is a device that can be used to lift the heavy loads by applying smaller efforts at its handle. Okay, now if you want to lift a heavy loads with the help of a smaller, very less effort, you can use this device. Now, especially number of public sector units or Indian Engineering Services are for GATE. Now, they are asking about this torque required to lift the load by a screw jack. See, when you unwound the screw from the screw jack, now it will looks like an inclined plane like this. Let us consider this is an inclined plane. When you unwound it, the distance measured, this distance will give the pitch of the screw, and this will give the pi d value. Okay, now let us consider P be the pitch of the screw, small d is equals to mean dia of the screw, alpha is equals to this, alpha is equals to helix angle, and P is equals to effort applied. So here I am applying the effort at the handle. Okay, now W is equals to load to be lifted, and mu is equals to coefficient of the friction between the screw and the nut. Now this is the case of the inclined plane. When a load is placed like this, definitely the weight or the load, because of the gravitational force, always acting vertically downwards like this. Okay, so this is the helix angle or the inclined angle. Now you can resolve this load into two components, that is horizontal component and the vertical component along the plane, W cos alpha and W sin alpha. Let us consider P be the effort. So this is the effort applied at the handle of the screw jack. Okay, now you can also resolve this effort into two components, that is horizontal component P cos alpha along the inclined plane, and P sin alpha, that is perpendicular to this inclined plane. Okay, let us consider F be the frictional force, which is always developed opposite to the direction of the motion, and this Rn be the normal reaction, which is developed against this weight of the body. Different forces on the inclined plane. Okay, now let us resolve these forces along the plane. Now if you resolve the forces along the plane, you will get this P cos alpha. Means resolve the forces along the inclined plane, means sum of all the sigma fx, means P cos alpha minus F and minus W sin alpha. Okay, P cos alpha minus F minus W sin alpha. So this equation you can write it as P cos alpha is equals to mu into Rn plus W into sin alpha. Okay, likewise you can also resolve the forces perpendicular to the plane. If you resolve the forces perpendicular to the plane, let us see the free body diagram. So Rn is the first force, so this is Rn. Okay, likewise Rn and W cos alpha and Rn and P sin alpha. So this is the P sin alpha. Okay, now you can resolve these forces like this, Rn minus W cos alpha minus P sin alpha. Okay, now substitute this Rn value in equation number 1. In this equation, what we will get? P cos alpha is equals to mu into, we know that Rn is equals to mu into P sin alpha plus W cos alpha plus W sin alpha. Okay, now take it as common, P as the common and W as the common values. P into cos alpha minus mu sin alpha is equals to W into sin alpha plus mu cos alpha. Now from this equation you can calculate this P. But we also know that this coefficient of the friction is equals to tan of the helix angle, where phi is equals to friction angle. Okay, now W into sin alpha plus tan phi into cos alpha divided by cos alpha minus tan phi into sin alpha. Now multiply this numerator and denominator with cos phi. Now p is equals to w into sin alpha cos alpha plus sin phi into cos alpha divided by cos alpha to cos phi minus sin phi into sin alpha. Okay, now you can multiply numerator and denominator with cos phi. Okay, from this equation you will get p is equals to this is in the form of sin a cos b plus cos a sin b divided by cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. So sin a plus b divided by cos a plus b. So w into tan alpha plus phi. Okay, now but we know that the torque applied at the handle, torque required at the handle is equals to p into mean diameter divided by 2, that is equals to w into tan alpha plus phi into d by 2. Okay, this is the equation how to derive. This is the procedure for the deriving a effort required and the torque required at the handle of the screw jack.